All right, Mario Van Peebles has got a lot of things figured out, and his daughter Morgana.
Yes.
I got it.
You got it.
Yay. Sci-fi hit Superstition. Dad and daughter are working together, which is terrific. We've been fans of your dad's for a long time.
Uh-oh.
Is it cool to have this kind of environment? Is it different, a professional setting, than just at home?
It is. I mean, I've been on set multiple times with my dad, but this is different, actually being directed by my father and actually getting to act in some scenes with him.
I get to tell her what to do into perpetuity. Go. It's great.
You know, get a few more months.
Right. And then we were talking before, you got to share this with the people at home, about that just the phrase that every dad hears from every daughter, "Oh, Dad." And you're saying there's
multiple. Morgana can give me, "Oh, Dad," which is, you know, chill out.
Right.
And then there's "Oh, Dad," which means car available.
Right.
And "Oh, Dad," meaning can I have friends over now?
Yeah.
But here's the thing. She's old enough and making her own money on this show. So it's, by the way, it's Superstition, but it's Sci-Fi Netflix.
Co-venture.
Okay. She's making enough money to get her own place. And she said, no, because we film in Atlanta. She said, I want to live with you.
Aww.
She's vegan.
Okay,
we're going healthy.
She's got you going vegan?
I'm vegan between meals.
Dabbling.
He does some meals.
Yeah.
Right. But, and, you know, in this show, we are a family that is, we have a funeral home, and we deal with the dead and the undead.
Mm. Wow.
So it's in the thriller horror space. It's fun. It's spooky. We're like the cool, we're like the Obamas meets the Addams family.
Okay.
That's a good long line. All right, back to the vegan thing. Was that a college phase, or did you get into vegan?
She's still in it.
No, I'm still in the phase.
Look at her.
I guess. Right.
I know. No, it's the proof's in the pudding. Yeah.
Thank you.
Hey, what do you mean by that?
No. Yikes! All right, back to the show. Did you feel? I mean, you don't want to be on that show just because you're his daughter.
Of course.
So you obviously demonstrate that you have the chops to do it. I had auditioned,
the whole thing.
Yeah.
You know, convinced them to let me take a gap semester, which was a big one.
Gap semester, by the way, from Columbia, no less. Not
impressive.
Bad.
So, you know, got some time off from New York.
What are you studying in school?
So I have a minor in visual arts, and I'm looking at a major in political science at the moment, or economics.
Don't
so
you hate when the kids are so much smarter than the parents? It just kills me.
But I think it's also women. I think, you know, what's that old saying? Women can play dumb, but men are born that way.
Yeah. You know,
my sons, I got
so
sons,
true.
Boy. And I do give them a gap year. After college, you get a gap, a daddy finance gap year at the house.
Right.
After that, you do what you want, but just don't do it at the house.
Right.
And she's been cool, so she can act.
We're
in the show together.
Yeah.
In the show, here's the deal. She plays my granddaughter.
So I can call him Grandpa, you know?
Because
funny.
My character, Isaac, is 778 years old.
Oh,
he has this magic ring, which I brought to show off.
Right.
Okay.
And he's got some infernals in this ring. And so black don't crack, and brown can stick around. I'm 778 years old.
Wow.
How about that?
I tell you what. But you know what? In a deep part of his consciousness that he's not revealing, when you say grandpa, it kills it.
Oh, just a little
bit. Oh, she doesn't know where
I get to pull it out sometimes. Right. Be like, grandpa.
Let's see, father and daughter, Gramps. Hard at work, brand new clip from the show. Take a look at this.
Sorry.
Don't be. You did your job. Now I'm gonna go do mine and figure this out.
Oh, that's a nice scene. That's a nice keepsake.
One of the things you find out is that the more that human beings destroy the planet, the more the infernals are coming through to put us in check. So the whole idea of balance and who's the bad guy depends on which end of the lens you look through.
Mm-hmm.
And so it puts our family, because we're sort of involved with sort of trying to keep the balance between quote-unquote good and evil, but it's less reductive than that once you go, wait a minute, we're the ones with the fires, we're the ones polluting, we're the ones making it difficult for all the other species to survive. Mm. So. It's a little nutritional value, I always think.
All right, which I think is good.
Yeah, love what you do.
Right.
Love, enjoy the folks you do it with.
Right.
And
love what you say with it. Love what you say with it.
Yeah.
And if you do,
you're
rich no matter what you check.
I'm loving this.
By the way, when's Superstition on? Do you know?
Thursdays at 11 p.m.
There you go, so. on the Sci-Fi channel. And before we say so long, how old were you when you first saw New Jack City?
Oh, my God, the first time.
Don't say it like that again.
Where's
that?
Oh, you see the dad?
You see the dad thing?
Right.
Oh, my God, dad.
Granddad.
Yeah.
10?
10 probably.
And when did you become cognizant of what I will describe as the family business to a degree? Dad, grandpa.
I think forever, to be honest. Mm. I've been on set since I was very young, and it just, I got the business in increments, so I started to see like the directing side of it, so I was more into that at the beginning, and then kind of writing my own stuff, and I started making my own short films, and then I've been doing theater my whole life.
She's a good film. But one of the fun things was that at a certain point, we met some folks that were a little hostile outside, and I said, kids, just cool it. And they said, no, Dad, you could just throw a tree at them. I had done a movie where in the stunt, my character had superpowers and threw trees and cars at bad guys. And I was like, Dad doesn't do that in real life.
You know? He throws trees around.
Yeah,
don't go
saying
that to everybody.
You know what? The next daddy-daughter book on this post-college gap year.
Yeah.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, we're enjoying it.
I'm just planning everyone's life.
A reality show about the gap year.
There we go.
The gap year. That's a good title.
Give
me a little credit.
Right. Casey was featured in Ray Donovan this past year. She's a big star herself.
I just played a news reporter. Well, it was not a stretch at all.
Superstition airs Thursdays at 11. It's on Sci-Fi. Dad and daughter, nice to see you both.
Thank you for having us.
Great. Good
Such
to see
a pleasure.
You.